adding sorts and filter to your HTML table, it's not that complicated. But with that, if you want to add animation, it might get tricky. In this video, you will learn how to use Fenla JavaScript to sort for specific data of an HTML table. And along with that, I'll show you how can you add beautiful animation. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone. This is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. If you want to go along with me, this is the code that I have taken from the last week's UI design video. In that video, I have shown you how can you build responsive HTML table without using any CSS frameworks. The video's link will be given in the description below or at top right corner in iCard you can check out. Now let's change the title. For the title, I'm giving real-time sorts and filter an HTML table using JavaScript, or you can call it sorts on HTML table. Now with the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser, and by pressing F11 key, let's take it to the full screen. Okay, this was the table that I have built last week. Now inside the section with class name table header, next to H1 heading, let's create div with class name input group, and inside that div I'm creating input with type sorts. And also let's give the placeholder. For the placeholder I'm giving sorts data, and next to that let's create image with source images slash source.png. so in the same folder you can see I have folder name images, and inside that folder you can find it out this source icon. Okay, by the way, you can use different, you know, third-party libraries to use different icons, but right now I'm not doing that. In the browser you can see that source icon is really huge, so before styling anything, first of all I think we have to style that source icon. And you can see I have already linked the style.css file. Now in the style.css file, let's give some css property for that source icon. So for that icon, let's give width and height of 1.2 rem. Okay, this is the exact size that I want. Now you can see our card heading that is totally messed up. So let's bring that heading in the same line. Okay, so for that, for the class table header, I can use something like flexbox. So I'm writing display flex. Justify content to space between. So now you can see with the help of that space between, our input group, they are taken at right corner. And also let's give align items to center. Let's select this code and duplicate it. Let's style class input group. For the class input group, let's give width of 35%. For the height I'm giving 100%. And also for the background color, let's give this white color with some transparent value. Similarly, let's give padding top and bottom to 0. For the left and right, I'm giving 0.8 rem. And for the border radius, let's give 2 rem. Once again, let's use flexbox. I'm giving display flex. Justify content to center. And align items to center. So now you can see all the contents within that class input group, they are aligned exactly at the center. Now let's style that input field. So once again, let's select this code and let's duplicate it. And instead of that image, let's give input. Now for the input, we don't need that height. Let's remove that. And for the width, let's change it to 100%. And also let's give padding. For the top, I'm giving 0. For the right, 0.5 rem. For the bottom, 0. And for the left padding, let's give 0.3 rem. So if you have noticed, I have given there 0.5 rem and 0.3 rem. Total, that makes 0.8 rem. So that 0.8 rem, that was the padding that I have given for the class input group. It was necessary to calculate that. It's because in order to give proper space and the gap between these elements. Similarly, let's remove that white background color of input field. So for the background color, let's keep transparent. Let's remove the border as well as the outline of this input field. So I'm giving border and outline none. Now when you hover that input group, I want to change width. So let's copy this code and let's paste it there. Now for the class input group, when you hover, let's change its width to 45%. We don't need that height. And also let's change that background color to more bright white color. Now you can see when you take your mouse to that input group, you will get some changes, but there is no any transition. Okay, so for the class input group, let's give the transition. Okay, for the transition duration, I'm giving 0.2 second. Now you can see when you take your mouse near that input group, you will get that smooth transition. I think we need to make it more brighter. So let's change the alpha value of that color. Similarly, let's give the box shadow. Okay. For the x offset, I'm giving 0. For the y offset, I'm giving 0.1 rem. For the spread value, 0.4 rem. And finally, for the color, let's give this black color with some transparent value. So now you can see when you hover. Okay, now this is perfect. Once again, now let's take it to the full screen by pressing F11 key. So now what you need to do is that whenever you are sourcing any data of this table, we need to add that source functionality. So in order to add that feature, we need to take the help of JavaScript code. So now let's create a script.js file. Just above the end of body tag, let's give the link for our script.js file. So now we need to select this input element and also all the table rows which are within the table body. Okay, for that, first of all, let's create constant variable sorts, and I am assigning document.querySelector. We want to select that input element which is within the class input group, and I'm using comma so that I don't have to write that constant keyword multiple times. Let's create another variable table rows, and I'm assigning document.querySelector all. I'm giving their query selector all. It's because I want to select all the table rows, okay, that is within the table body. So for that, I'm writing their query selector all. Let's select that table row. Now, whenever you are typing anything in that sorts field, we need to trigger some events. So for that, for the sorts, I'm adding event listener, and for the event, let's give input. For the second parameter, let's give the function sorts table. But as you can see, we haven't created that sorts table function. So now let's create that sorts table function. Now, as soon as you type anything in that source field, we need to iterate all the table rows. So for that, you can write something like table rows dot. So I'm using this for each function to iterate all the table rows, and inside that you can give each table row with its index. And now inside that error function, I want to console.log each row's text. So for that, I'm writing row.text content. Once again in the browser, let's press F12 key, and if you go to the console tab, okay, we have got some error. Okay, it's because like input element that was within the D with class name input group. So input group, that was the class, so I have to give their dot. Now, once again in the browser, if I type anything in that sorts field in console, did you see that? We are getting each and every value of tables row. Okay, so this is exactly what we want. Now, what we can do is that we can store that value inside the variable table data. And also, now we need to get source value that you have typed in the source field. Inside the source data variable, you can store something like the data that you have sourced in the source field. So in order to get that source data value, what you can do is that with the help of source variable, you can write something like source dot value. Now you can source whether all the data that you have in your table, whether all those data, they are matching with the source data or not. Okay, so for that, you can write something like table data dot index of, and inside that method you can pass source data. So let's see it in the console, okay, what kind of value that we are going to get. Once again in the source field, if I type j in the console, did you see that? You are getting -1. That means there is no any data that matches with letter j. So what if I give different value? In the console, you can see you'll get 0 or more than 0 value if your source data is matched with table data. Okay, so with the help of this logic, what you can do is that instead of that console.log, let's give the table row that we have iterated, and you can give something like dot class list dot, and you can give toggle. So we are adding and removing the class hide, and you can give comma. And for the second parameter, we are giving the condition that will return the boolean value. So previously we can see that in the console, whenever source data didn't match with table data, at the time we were getting -1, and if it did match, we were getting 0 or more than 0. Okay, so now with the help of that value, you can give something like less than 0. So the condition is that if the source data didn't match with the table data at the time, we are giving class hide. Otherwise, we are removing that class hide from the table row. Let's go back to the browser and let's go to the element tab. When I source any value, did you see that? For all the table rows, we are giving class height. Once again, let's give different value. So if it did match with any value, we will remove the class height. So that's what's going on here. But now for the table row, in a standard CSS file, we need to give that class height. So for the table row that is within the table body, when we are giving class height at the time, let's keep opacity to 0. And I'm giving transform translate x to 100%. So once again in the browser, let's search the value. Okay, it didn't match, so everything is hidden from that table, but there was no any transition. Okay, in order to give that smooth transition, let's duplicate this code. For the table row, let's give the delay CSS variable and I'm giving 0.1 second. Now let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I'm giving 0.5 second. For the timing function, let's give easing out, and for the third value, let's give the transition delay. So we are giving that delay CSS variable. Later on with the help of JavaScript code, we are going to change that delay CSS variables value, and we don't need that class height. Let's remove that in the browser. If I remove that source value, did you see that? We are getting that smooth transition. As you can see, transition is applied, but I want to apply different transition value for the different table row. So in order to do that, as you can see, I have already declared their delay CSS variable. So we'll change that delay CSS variables value dynamically with the help of JavaScript code. You can write something like row.style.set property. So we are changing the CSS property, that is the delay CSS variable. And for the second parameter, you can give the value. So as you can see, I have already retrieved index of each table row with that I variable. So that I represents the individual position of table row that is within the table body. So now I can write something like I divide by 25 plus I'm concatenating string s. So I'm dividing by 25, it's because I don't want to give 1 second, 2 second or 3 second, so I want to give it really short transition delay. And the reason for adding string s, as you can see, delay CSS variable, it takes the value with time unit second, so it is really necessary to give that string second in the browser. Once again, did you see that whenever I'm sourcing anything, you will get different transition within the different table rows? But I have noticed there, when you hover any table rows, transition value is applied for that background color too. So in order to prevent that, for the transition duration, instead of that 0.5 second, for the background color we'll give transition duration to 0 second. So for the background color, that transition won't be applied. Once again in the browser, you can see now whenever you are hovering table rows, you are getting that bright color without any transition. Although all the values that didn't match with the table data, they all are hidden, but still they are occupying different space within the table. So in order to prevent that, you can see for the different table data, we have given their image, table data value, paragraph elements, so they are occupying different space within that table row. So we can prevent this by changing their width and height, font size, or if you have given their padding value, we can change that. So now whenever you are changing any CSS property of table data, image and the paragraph that is within the table data, we have to give transition in order to get the smooth transition. Okay, so for that, for the table data, I'm giving transition duration of 0.2 second and for the timing function is in out. Once again, let's copy this code and let's paste it there. Now for the table data and the paragraph that is within the table data, whenever you are giving class height for the table row, at that time we want to change the table data and paragraphs padding to 0. So as you can see, for the table data, I have given their padding of 1 rem, and for the paragraph, I have given their 0.4 rem. So we are changing back to 0. And also let's change the font. For the font size, I am giving 0. For the line height, 0. But for the font family, let's keep it the same sans serif. Similarly, let's duplicate the same transition code and let's bring it down. And once again, when you are giving that class height for the table row at that time, let's change that image of table data. So for the image, I'm giving width and height of 0. And also let's give the same transition. In the browser, did you see that all the hidden table data, they are not occupying extra space, and also you are getting that smooth transition. Isn't that beautiful? But if you have noticed, their transition is really quick. So for the table data, paragraph and image, when you are giving class height for the table row at that time, we have to give the transition delay. So for the transition delay, I'm giving 0.5 second. So if you ask me why 0.5 second, it's because you can see for the table row, I have given transition duration of 0.5 second, so I'm giving the same transition duration as transition delay. So once again in the browser, did you see that? Now you are getting that cool animation, cool transition. But if you have noticed there, when I am typing J, everything is hidden. And if you look carefully at table data, there are different data with letter J, but they are in capital letters. So our source functionality is case sensitive. So you can write something like text content dot to lowercase. With the help of this method, we are changing all the data that is within the table row into lowercase. Similarly, we need to apply the same thing for the value that you have sorts. I'm giving the same dot to lowercase method. Now once again in the browser, did you see that? Now our sorts functionality that is not case sensitive. And also if you have noticed, there is another problem. Although we are getting all the match sorts data, but if you have looked carefully, we're not getting that strip table. So now what you can do is that I can write something like document.query selector all, and we are selecting table row that is within the table body, and I'm giving not pseudo class. So let me show you in the CSS file. What you can do is that with the help of that not pseudo class, I can pass their height class. So with the help of this code, we are selecting each and every table row that is within the table body except with class height. So now let's paste the same code there. As you can see, we are selecting all the table rows that doesn't contain class height. Now we need to iterate all those table rows. So as you can see, previously I have used for each function. Once again, let's use the for each function. Now let's change that row to something like visible row. Although you can keep the same row, I think it makes more sense, you know, if you give visible row. Now for each visible row, you can give something like visible row dot style dot background color is equal to, and as you know that I represents the each position of visible row. So now with the help of that I can write something like within the small bracket I mod 2 is equal to, that should be double equal to because that is the comparison operator. I'm giving 0. I think you have already know like what we are doing. So we are checking whether that visible row's position, whether it is even. So if the visible row's position is even, I'm using ternary operator. So if the visible row's position that is even at the time, we are giving the background color of transparent. Otherwise we are giving the same background color. As you can see, for the all table row which was in the even position, we have given their black color with extreme, you know, high alpha value. So let's give the same black color. So once again in the browser, let's source the data. Now did you see that we are getting that strip table? Again we are getting another problem. Whenever you are hovering table data, we are not getting that background color of bright color. Let's keep their extra property, exclamatory sign important. Now in the browser you can see, whenever you are hovering the table rows, you are getting that bright background color, and whenever you are sorting anything, you can see everything is working completely fine. If you have noticed carefully, we have given their custom scroll bar, but that custom scroll bar that is occupying the extra width. Okay, in order to prevent that, now you can give in the standard CSS file, you can see for the class table body, I have given their overflow of auto. Now I need to give extra code, something like overflow to overlay. So now with the help of this code in the browser, you can see that scroll bar that is now included within the table body. Now you can see everything is working completely fine. So this is exactly what you want. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it. And also, if you haven't already ate, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn. So keep learning.